Welcome to Crypto Jargon, the series where I'm breaking down the complex terminology related to cryptocurrencies and blockchain technology. In this episode, the topic is software changes and upgrades, known as forks. There are a few different types of forks, so let's explain the differences. First, what is a fork? In programming terms, a fork is a permanent modification, upgrade, divergence, or simply any change in the original code of a software. Forks generally happen in the crypto world when new rules are built into a blockchain's code. Sometimes a fork is used to test a process, but with cryptocurrencies, it is mostly used to implement a fundamental change or to create a new asset with similar but not equal characteristics as the original. There are two main types of programming forks, hard and soft. A soft fork is an upgrade in the software that is compatible with the original version. When the changes are implemented, they are backward compatible, meaning that even users who haven't upgraded to the new software are still able to run their nodes and mine blocks on that blockchain. In the case of SegWit, for instance, which was a soft fork on the Bitcoin blockchain protocol, users and node operators could choose if they want to run the older version, legacy, or the new version, SegWit. And still, to this day, there are certain economical nodes such as the blockchain.com wallet and Jax wallet and KeepKey, for instance, which are running the legacy version, and you can tell by the wallet address. A legacy Bitcoin address begins with the number 1, while SegWit wallet address begins with the number 3. A user-activated soft fork is when a soft fork is activated on a specific date and is enforced by full nodes, a concept sometimes referred to as the economic majority. A user-activated soft fork requires a lot of industry support and coordination. Originally, SegWit was going to be implemented as a user-activated soft fork, and as a response to that, Bitmain, a major mining firm, announced a contingency plan against it in the form of user-activated hard fork, which they did anyway, and thus Bitcoin Cash was born. A hard fork is an upgrade in the software that requires all users to switch to the new version of that software. It is not backward compatible, meaning that anyone who wants to mine blocks on that blockchain has to use the latest version of the code. It can be a planned hard fork, which is simply an upgrade to the protocol that had already been made clear in advance by the project developers, and there is no conflict in its implementation. Usually, a high degree of consensus from the project developers and the community would have already been reached before the hard fork occurred. Examples of a planned hard fork is Monero's hard fork in January of 2017, which saw the addition of a new privacy feature known as Ring Confidential Transactions, and the 2019 Ethereum change to a proof-of-stake protocol, which was announced years ahead of its implementation. In this regard, it's also known as a non-contentious hard fork, which means everyone upgrades and moves on. The opposite is a contentious hard fork, which is not being accepted by everyone, and some users decide to continue running the older version, and this way the chain splits into two. One path which follows the new upgraded blockchain, and one path which continues along the old blockchain version. This is how Ethereum Classic was created, and also Bitcoin Cash when it split from Bitcoin in 2017. A hard fork can also be initiated if a 51% attack occurs or due to a bug in the system, so it doesn't always create a new coin. A user-activated hard fork is where the developers add a mandatory rule set to change the node software. These changes make previously invalid blocks become valid after a flag day, which does not require a majority of hash power to be enforced. The signaling for consensus on a hard fork proposal can also be handed to the miners, which is known as a miner-activated soft fork. The most significant example of applying user-activated soft fork and user-activated hard fork is the forking of Ethereum in May 2006. Ethereum started the DAO project, but a month later, that project was hacked and the sum of about $55 million was stolen. This amounted to more than 10% of the circulating supply of Ether at the time, and after the incident, three solutions were suggested. first was to accept the theft and do nothing. The second was to roll back the blockchain to the time before the theft, which would be through a hard fork. And the third was to accept all transactions to the hacker's wallet false and return the money back, which would be done as a soft fork. The Ethereum community chose to go with the second proposal, but some users weren't happy with that. They assumed that code is law, which is the main concept of the cryptocurrency, and they accepted the theft and decided to stick to the original version without any rollback. So when the hard fork was executed, there were two chains, one that is known as Ethereum and another known as Ethereum Classic. There are also accidental forks, a rare occasion when two or more blocks have the same block height, forking the blockchain. This can also happen as part of an attack, but they don't really create new coins, and the longest chain is the one that prevails. So the one that has the greater hashing power and the longest history of blocks is the original chain and will be considered as the dominant and the main chain. Enjoying this content? Go check out Crypto Jargon, the ebook, out now on Kindle. It's an Amazon bestseller and it's the most up-to-date crypto dictionary with more than 700 terms, acronyms and trading slang related to cryptocurrencies and blockchain tech. Just go to ojjordan.com/cryptojargon and grab your digital copy today.